Today we're going to be talking about one of our protected species. So a species that you're not or shouldn't be targeting. The potato bass, otherwise known as a spud, or if you want to be scientific, Epinephilus tucula. Quite a nice name, easy to word, rolls off the tongue. In terms of color wise, you're looking at a sandy olive kind of color fish. Quite a difficult one to describe, very similar to a catfish rock cod color. Elongate. As they get older, much like the rock cods, their stomachs do distend, so they become a bit more bulky. But the main difference is they've got these big blotches, which look like potato marks, all the way along on their body. An interesting fact is that they can actually change the little cells are called chromatophores. They can actually change the cells on their skin, so they can go completely white, completely dark, which is a thing that many of the fish actually do have. But in potato bass, it's very obvious to see because those patches will disappear or the whole fish will go dark. They are reef-associated predators. As we said, they are listed as a protected species. So much like the great white, the brindle bass, you aren't allowed to target them. And if you do, you, by regulation, are meant to cut the line as soon as you know it is a potato bass. In my opinion, not the opinion of ASFN, I do still think you should land the fish as safely as possible and release it. But by law, you are meant to cut the line as soon as you know it is a potato bass. But that is quite a contentious issue. You'll see on many of the Facebook pages and whatnot, there are a lot of very long debates about it. Otherwise, appearance-wise, very, very big mouth. They've got plates of teeth, so like similar to how we mentioned with the sandpaper-like teeth of the Australians or the garrick and the queenfish, they have got these rows of teeth, but unlike those, it's not a plate. It's needle sharp teeth. If you've ever landed one, they are extremely hardy on your hands. You'll walk away with a lot of blood if you don't wear a glove. And that's for their feeding method. So big strong jaws, sharp gripping teeth. You're looking at crayfish, all of the fish species, and literally anything else that it can get its teeth on. They will grab, drown, or disable, and swallow everything whole. The potato bass is really, he's the big boss. Everything on the reef is scared of that potato bass. I've seen them ram tiger sharks that are 4 meters in length. You just hit them in the gills and knock whatever the tiger shark was eating out and take it and run away. They'll beat a big GT. They are the big bad boys of the reef. They have been known to be quite aggressive towards people. There have been spear fishermen that have been drowned before, but with potato bass grabbing them and holding them under. It's really more of urban legend. Interesting enough, the species name, tucula, comes from the Mangalesh word for man-eater. So I think that sort of fed into that a lot of that urban legend side of things. Very, very powerful fish. Like we said, reef associated, so they're going to be around coral reefs. There's not a lot of information or research that's been done on their life history, so there's quite a lot of mystery behind it, which is quite exciting. It means there's something that we can still learn about them. And also their breeding habits, there's really not a lot known about them. But yeah, they're protected species. They mature at 90 centimeters, so it's quite a big fish. In terms of the size, there's a lot of guys will tell you get to 500 kilos, you know, 800 kilos, but you're looking at a fish that's sort of going to max out 150 kilos, maybe to 200. So some of the books are a little bit out on that, but yeah, you're not really going to catch one bigger than 150 kilos, and if you land one over 50, it's quite an achievement. They're very, very strong. Very, very powerful fish. The one thing about the potato bass, on the more popular diving reefs, they become very charismatic. So up north in the reserves and things like that, they are very scared of people. They will eye you out. You do get a kind of feeling that he's sizing you up, seeing if he can eat you. But on the diving reefs, they become very popular. They become one of the features that you go and see. So if you do go up to Sodwana, speak to the divers there, you'll see their eyes will twinkle a little bit and they talk about their pets. So there are a lot of them that have potato bass that have got names. They stay in the same hole year after year. As we said, there's not a lot of study that's been done about their movement, so we don't know if they're just staying there or if they do move north to breed or whatnot. But yeah, they're a charismatic species. They're one that could be a lot of fun to target if you were allowed to, but as we mentioned right at the beginning, and we are reiterating now, you are not allowed to target them. So learn about the potato bass, go have a look at them at Ushaka, see them in their natural habitat, maybe when you go snorkeling. So guys, this is one of the species that's on our species list, but not for your target species list. So don't go out and catch one. Cheers.